Greetings, fellow citizens. This is not another Hammerhead video. It's a Valkyrie video. This video will be a tour of the Valkyrie. We will fly to Shubin and I will try to load some vehicles inside. Now I don't own a Valkyrie. This thing didn't really interest me much. It's not a bad ship, it's a dropship and it's very good at what it does, I'm sure about it. But this wasn't something I wanted to have in my fleet for now. So why can I play with a Valkyrie if I don't own it? Well, again, Jack Axton stepped in and gave me access to his Valkyrie, so I can play a bit with it and make a video. By the way, Jack Axton was on CitizenCon, and here's a video with him. He is the gentleman on the right side with his Drake jacket. Thank you very much again, Jack.
How's it going? Can I give you the microphone? And
yeah.
All right, thank you very much. So you just saw the Kraken reveal.
Oh yeah.
What do you think of the trailer?
Okay, so I'm definitely gonna have to be wiping my wallet for this. Everyone always wants a carrier. I feel like this is the first carrier actually made for civilians. Obviously Drake has a massive history of catering to civilians. Civilians are always asking for something to carry other ships around. I was hoping, as you can see, I've got the Kraken logo down here, and looks like Drake finally came through for us. We've actually got something for the civilians. Finally, military UE can rest a bit easy. People trying to buy those surplus Idrises, and finally we've got this thing right here.
So you've kind of been waiting for a ship like this for a long time now.
Like, you know, we heard originally, oh, it'd be like a strip mall, essentially. It'd be like some sort of, you know, Banu merchantman just for humans. Now we've actually got something to call our own. We actually have the carrier people have been asking for 4 years. So Idris can step aside, Javelin can step aside, Drake's actually back in town, and I feel like they came through.
I mean, it's kind of obvious. You as a Drake fan would say
that,
right?
Yeah, you know, like you could say I might be a little bit of a Drake fan. I mean, you might be able to call me biased, but I think that bias is probably rooted in actual fact now.
So let's take a look around in flight. Lower landing gear. More light. And raise landing gear. And we have a turret on top. And turret on the bottom and some guns for the pilot. And we have some guns on the wings for the ground attack roll, I think. This thing is much bigger than I thought. And it looks cool. We are in the pipe, 5x5. Let's fly to Shubin. So a few more thoughts while we are closing in to Shubin. The ship doesn't have any engine sound right now. And as you saw, there are still some placeholder graphics. Another thing, Chris, why can't I raise my seat? I don't need to see this, but I would like to see more of those things. Well, luckily we have track IR. So I just raised my seat using track IR. I really hope we get the option to raise and lower our seats. I'm turning track IR off again. So we will land at Shubin now, and then I will give you a tour of the Valkyrie. Luckily we have daylight, that's very nice. And then I will load a few things into it. Hopefully the game doesn't crash. And this is really strange to fly without any sound, not even the wind sound. But those things I get fixed very quickly usually. Okay, I'm lowering landing gear. By the way, there's a window in the floor, I think. Let's activate track IR again. Yeah, look at this. You can see down to the ground. This makes landing a lot easier, I think. Yeah, I still need the outside view. But it's a nice feature of the Valkyrie. Yeah. I can see below me. Hopefully in the future all ships get something like a camera that's just pointing down and that you can display on one of your MFDs. And we are going down. I still like to use the outside view. Because it looks nicer. And get her down gently. We have arrived. So let's start the tour. This is a cockpit with one seat. I guess these are the side turrets for air-to-ground attacks. Nice touch. What's this? Okay, you have your toilet and you have one bed. Okay, a few more. A few more beds. And here as well, and another seat for the top turret. Then you have to use this ladder to go down. Come on, crabby hands. And here you have seats for your marines.
All right, sweethearts, what are you waiting for? Breakfast in bed?
Another glorious day in the Corps.
This is the access to the bottom turret. And more seats for your marines. And you have a big room to store your vehicles. And a big ramp. Let's open it. Oh, for a second I thought I would have crashed. And here's the Valkyrie in all her beauty. Actually, I don't have too many things to complain about. I really would love to be able to raise my seat though, Chris, please. And I hope in the future we will have tall people and small people, so you must be able to adjust your seat anyway. Yeah, you can really do a lot of damage with this ship if you are going for a raid on the ground installation. I'm pretty much sure that a Tonk won't fit, but if I'm wrong, please leave a comment. Next, we will spawn some ground vehicles and load them into the Valkyrie. I still only have the standard Cyclone available. I have a Cyclone TR on my account, and I hope we get it soon. What's happening? Okay. Physics. There's lots of space for vehicles. I like this very much. Maybe I can spawn an Ursa rover and try this one as well. And maybe I should have parked closer. Well, don't worry, I will make cuts. And I was wrong, actually I can spawn a Cyclone TR. It's the one with the turret on top. It was at the end of the list, and first time I tried to spawn a vehicle, the list didn't scroll down fully. So now we have the Cyclone with the turret on top. This will be a fun vehicle. Start. Hey, the other vehicle is still in. Let's see if we can store two Cyclones inside. Not like this. Where did you learn driving? Come on. Yeah, that's cool. I hope I can get out here. Yeah. So now we have two Cyclones. Let's get more. Let's get an Ursa. This is fun. And we have an Ursa rover. Is the door still bugged? No. Yeah, the Cyclones are still inside. That's funny. Let's see if we can store two Cyclones and one Ursa rover inside. Looks like I can't get in, even though there's still a lot of space. Oh, I can. That's a tight fit, I tell you. Okay, let's get out of the pilot seat, the driver's seat. Let's see how tight this is. It's very tight. But I think with a little bit of optimization, this can be done. Oh, I didn't know that you can store that many vehicles inside the Valkyrie. That's fun. Let's wave to him. I would love it if chat would work. Let's do the Let's do the chat that always works, just jump around. It's a good old jumping around chat. So I think with a little bit of optimization you can store maybe two Cyclones and an Ursa rover inside. That's not a bad thing. And I'm crashing. No, I'm not crashing. There's a little bit of stuttering now and then. Here's a bottom turret. Let's see if we can lift off with our load. Okay, let's try to go to the ramp. This won't be easy with so many vehicles stored inside. Maybe I find a bit of... Oh, okay, this wasn't too bad, actually. So, back to the cockpit. Into the cockpit seat. Outside view with our load of two Cyclones and one Ursa rover and lift off. Hey, it worked. Everything is fine, no worries. Everything is secured. I love this game. It's magic. I still think I won't buy a Valkyrie, since like I said, it's not my cup of tea, but it will be a very useful ship if you or your orc wants to attack a ground installation. Let's try one more thing. Let's go into the turrets, let's go into the seats for the side turrets. Maybe I can use those. And I want to see the interface. Enter remote turret where nothing happens. I'm pressing F and click in. Either I'm doing something wrong, then please leave a comment. Either I'm doing something wrong, then please leave a comment, or this doesn't work yet. But it worked at CitizenCon, Chris! Okay, let's get off again. So, this was my short tour of the Valkyrie, and I had no idea that so many vehicles can fit into it. I hope you had fun watching my video, and see you next time. Bye!